Namaskara, I am Hampi Odi, Professor of Mathematics from KLS Gopti Institute of Technology, Belagavi. Welcome to e-Shikshan, my third lecture. I am dealing with 4th semester mathematics, 18 Math 41, 5th module. I am teaching at present sampling theory. Two lectures are over. In these two lectures, we have dealt with testing of hypothesis for large sample using Z statistic and small sample using T distribution. Students t-distribution. Today we are going to learn about, suppose we propose a theory and we list some theoretical values, some experimental values. According to the theoretical values, some 10 values we suppose note down. Same thing we find experimentally, that is observed values. How much better correct our experiment and observed values they are fitting. Whatever the theory we have fit, how much good it is using the observed values, we'll be testing. Whatever the data we are getting and theory we are proposing, how they are matching. That is the except terms of the theory using the observed values. Quite interesting. Let us see. And these are my details as usual. I show it to you. And today we are dealing with what is meant by chi-square distribution. This chi-square test, just like t-test, measures the correspondence between theory and practical, between theory and observation. If OI is a set of observed frequencies and EI is a set of expected frequencies, then what is the agreement between those two is tested by this chi-square. We pronounce it as chi-square, not chi-square, chi-square test. And the statistic is given by observed frequency minus expected frequency whole square divided by EI expected frequency. This summation of all such values for n observations, we take it for n minus 1 degrees of freedom. And here also there will be a table of values. We compare the table of values to this calculated value. And you are tuned to this type of examples now. You find some calculated value and compare with the table value. If less than table value accepted, here also similar. If more than table value, reject. That is chi-square test as a test of goodness of fit. Whatever the course we are fitting, whatever the theory we are fitting, using the observed values, what is the goodness of that? Whether it is good or not good, we fit. Whether binomial is better for that or Poisson distribution is better for the given values. Chi-square test enables us to ascertain how well the theoretical values, such as a theoretical distribution such as binomial, Poisson or normal, etc., fit our empirical distributions, that is distributions obtained from the observed or sample data. All these can be understood by these examples. In this, suppose first example, among 64 offsprings of a certain cross between pigs, suppose there are 64 pigs sample is there, out of that 34, 10 and 20 are of different type, 34 are red, 10 are black, 20 are white. These are the observed data. But according to genetic model, these numbers showed in a proportion to be 9:3:4. Whether this data and this data almost agree at 95% confidence limits or not. So remember, total 64, 34, 10, 20 observed values, 9:3:4 is a theory. Now how do we test it, whether theory and practical agree? First of all, we should make an hypothesis, which I forgot. Hypothesis is theory agrees with the practical values. Now in this theory, 9:3:4 means out of 16 we have got 9 picks red, 3 picks black and 4 picks white. Out of 69 means out of 64, why I am calculating out of 64? Because in the observed data, out of 64 is there. So theory also we multiply, out of 64 only we calculate. Theory is out of 16, we multiply by 4, 4, 4 everywhere. 9 4s are 36, 3 4s are 12 and 4 4s are 16. So we make the ratio for out of 64 means everywhere you multiply by 4, 4, 4 or out of 16, 9, out of 64, 36. So when you make it 4 times, you are going to get 36, 12 and 16. So instead of that, 9 picks out of 16, 3 picks out of 16, 4 picks out of 16, red, black, white. So out of 69, out of 64, 36 red. Similarly, out of 64, 12 black. Out of 64, 16 white as per the observed data. So these are the observed data O1, O2, O3, observed data, theoretical data, expected data E1, E2, E3. Now what is the theoretical data given? Observed data is given as 34, 10, 20. These are the actually observed values. Go to certain place, collect some 64 picks, and out of that 34, 10 and 20 according to different distributions. These are the calculated means expected values 36, 12, 16 according to theory. 36, 12, just now we calculated 36, 12, 16, red, black, white. 36, 12, 16. How do we calculate now this chi-square? 34 minus 36, observed minus expected, whole square, 36 minus 36, whole square, divided by 36. This becomes first one, plus 10 minus 12, whole square, divided by 12. 20 minus 16, whole square, divided by 16. Once again, what do we get? OI minus EI means 34 minus 36 means maybe minus 2. Minus 2 whole square is plus 4. Divided by EI, corresponding EI is 36. 10 minus 12, that is 2, difference is 2, 2 whole square is 4 again, divided by 12. So divided by 36, divided by 12, divided by 16, divided by EI will be there. Here, 20 minus 16 is 4, 20 minus 16, 4, that's whole square, 16, divided by 16. Sum of all these becomes 1.45. Now this will be, total 3 values are there, we drop 1, hence it becomes 3 minus 1. 2 degrees of freedom, because we know the total. When I know the total, if 1 is not given, you can find the other remaining. If 2 are given, you can find the remaining. So only thing is 2 is enough to know the remaining, because when the total is known as 64, when the total is known as 64, if I don't give 20, 2 are enough. That's why give 2 degrees of freedom. Now chi square calculated is 1.45, chi square table value is 5.99 for 2 degrees of freedom. So for one example, I'll show you, it is very, very similar to t-distribution table. How we got this 5.99 for 2 degrees of freedom? Here it is. Such a chi-square table you get, these are the degrees of freedom. Here 2 degrees of freedom, you go straight. Here 0.05 means 95% confidence. This is 5.99. This value we take. Suppose I have got 9 degrees of freedom and I want to have 99% confidence. So this is 99% confidence or 0.01 degrees level of significance. Here 0.01 is there. So come vertically down and join to horizontally 9 like this. 9, 9, 9, 9. Last one is 99% confidence, 21 point whatever it is. Here 10 point whatever it is for 9 degrees of freedom. In our case, 2 degrees of freedom, 95, 5.99, which we have noted down. Calculated value is less than table value, whatever the H naught is there, which we did not make H naught, theory and practical values, expected frequencies and observed frequencies agree. So we accept the hypothesis that genetic model is accepted. So here is the data consistent with the genetic model. The theory, you should make a H naught here before this. H naught is genetic model can be accepted. So if it is rejected, genetic model cannot be accepted. Since we are accepting the test, hence genetic model is accepted. Now, suppose we are asked to fit a Poisson distribution for this following data. You are given X, you are given F, and whether the Poisson distribution is good, whether the distribution is not correct, that is goodness of that fit, Poisson distribution we are fitting, that goodness of fit we have to test for 3 degrees of freedom. That is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, though it is 5, why 3 degrees of freedom? That is very important. Observe, keep on observing. Our first task is to frame the hypothesis whether Poisson distribution is good fit. Yes, we say yes, Poisson distribution is a good fit. If hypothesis is accepted, we say yes for this. If hypothesis is rejected, we say it is not a good fit. Now, first of all, to fit a Poisson distribution, if you recollect your one of the chapters, to fit a Poisson distribution, you have to find the mean of this. How do we find mean of this? Summation fx by summation, it should be f, please. The mistake here, summation f. What is fx? 122 into 0, 0 plus 16 into 1, 60, plus 15 into 2, 30, plus 2 into 3, 6, plus 1 into 4, 4, divided by sum of all these, which is 200. So that is mean is 0.5. So when I fit that Poisson distribution, simply m you have to write 0.5, p of x equal to e raised to minus 0.5, m raised to 0.5 divided by x factorial. So these values you should find, frequencies you should find theoretically also, by putting 0, 1, 2, 3, 4 and multiplying by total value 200, because total is 200. How do we find it? T of 0 means 200 into e raised to minus 0.5, e raised to 0.5. So for x you have to put 0, for x you have to put 1, for x you have to put 2, like that. Every time you have to multiply by 200. Put x equal to 0, find the value, multiply by 200. Put x equal to 0 here. So whatever the value you get, multiply by 200, you get 121. Put x equal to 1, multiply by 200, okay, you will get 61. Put x equal to 2 here, 0.5 raised to 2, e raised to minus 0.5, 2 factorial, whatever value you get, multiply by 200, you will get 15. Put x equal to 3 here, multiply by 200, third frequency is 3, these are all theoretical frequencies. Put x equal to 4, you will get 0. So these values, which we got it now, 121, 61, 15, 3, 0, we note down this along with expected frequencies. So these are the given values, 122, 60, 15 and 2 and 1. And similarly, 121 just now calculated value, 121 just now calculated value, next one is 61, next one is 15, next one is 61, next one is 15, similarly 30. Now there is a difference between these two tables. How many values are there here? First of all, let me clear once again. Observed frequencies, first we write given frequencies, observed frequencies, 122, 60, 15, 2, 1. So 122, 50, 60, 15, 2, 1. Expected frequencies theoretically calculated, we write below that EI, 121, 16, 1 and all that. Now how many values are there? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. But what we usually do is, if the frequencies are less than 5, the last two frequencies we add, like 2 plus 1 becomes 3, we note down 3 here, and 3 plus 0 becomes 3, we note down 3 here. So instead of 5, we got now 1, 2, 3, 4 values. So our sample size becomes now n equal to 4, like that. So n minus 1 means 4 minus 1, we have to find the table value for 3 degrees of freedom. So for calculation purpose, 122 minus 121 whole square, 60 minus 61 whole square, 15 minus 15 whole square, 3 minus 3 whole square. We discard this after adding last two frequencies because these two are less than 5. So very small, so that we make it bigger, better one. How do you find? Chi square is y minus ei whole square divided by ei. That is, once again I am telling you, difference of these two, 122 minus 121 whole square, 1 upon 121. 60 minus 61 whole square, that is 1 upon 16. This is 15 minus 15, 0, and 3 minus 3, 0. So when you add this, we are going to get 0.025. This 0.025 we compare with the chi-square table value at 95 degrees of confidence for 3 degrees of freedom, 7.815. So this table value is bigger, that is, calculated value is smaller. Whatever we are assuming is correct. So whatever Poisson distribution is there, it is correct. Now, similarly, we check it for binomial also. Coins are tossed 100 times and the following results are obtained. Okay. Fit a binomial distribution for the data and test the goodness of it. So now, whenever we throw some coins, we are going to have observed frequencies, expected frequencies. So now, what is the value? Fit a binomial distribution for the data and test the goodness of it. Now, number of heads, 0, 1, 2, 3, 4. So here, actually 4 is missing. We are tossing 4 coins. So here, please note down, it is 4 coins are tossed 100 times and following results were obtained. So number of heads, 0 number of heads we got 5 times. When we throw four coins. All the coins may not get head. All the coins may be tails. So zero heads we got 5 times out of 100 times. So 4 times you have 4 coins you are tossing once. 4 times coins you are tossing twice, 2 times. 4 coins you are tossing 3 times. Like that you go on tossing 100 times. Every time you note down number of heads and not number of heads. That is, number of heads are 0 heads 5 times. Only one head has occurred 29 times. 2 heads have occurred 36 times. 3 heads have occurred 25 times. 4 heads have occurred 5 times. Now 5 plus 5, 10. 6 plus 9, 15. 15 plus 5, 20. Totally, if you add, you are going to get 100 here. Now, whether binomial distribution is a good fit for this is a question. First, make an assumption that binomial distribution is a good fit. Theoretically, this is observed value, practical value. Theoretically, also, you calculate the binomial distribution values. How you find binomial distribution values theoretically? Let us recollect. First, find frequency, that is mean, using this frequency distribution. Summation f, suppose this is x, this is f, fx by summation f. Summation f is 100, you know it. 5 into 0, 0, 29 into 1, 1, that is I am doing fx. 36 into 2, 72, 25 into 3, 75, 5 into 4, 20, fx is over, summation fx is over, divided by summation f means total number of times coins are tossed. So we get mean as 1.96. Now I proceed ahead. For binomial distribution, mean is n into p. N is, so that is p is 1.96. What is the mean we got here? 1.96. So that number of times, number of coins are 4. So that 1.96, n is 4, sample size is 4, 4 coins are there. So sample size is 4, 1.96 into 4, which is 4p. P equal to 0.49. For a binomial distribution, you need P and Q. Yes and no. Success is yes, failure is no. So that if you know P, it is 1 minus P is Q. You can find P is 0.49, Q is 0.51, N is 4. So hence, binomial distribution is T of X equal to 100 into 4CX, where N is there, you put 4. Where P and Q are there, you put 0.49, 0.51. Now, how do you find these expected frequencies? Go on putting x equal to 0, 1, 2, 3, 4 and multiply by 100. First you put 0, find the values, multiply by 100. Then you put 1, find the value and multiply by 100. Then you put 2, 4c2, this raised to 2, this raised to 4 minus 2, multiply by 100. Suppose you put 3 here, 4c3, 0.49 raised to 3, 0.51 raised to 4 minus 3, that is 1, multiply by 100. If you go on finding T of 0, T of 1, T of 2, T of 3, T of 4, they are theoretical values or expected values. So like that you get T of 0 equal to 7, T of 1 equal to 26, T of 2, 3 and 4 are respectively 37, 24, 6. Let us have a table for this. Observed frequency, that is given frequencies. Theoretical frequency, that is just now calculated values, here they are shown. Chi-square means observed frequencies minus expected frequencies whole square divided by EI. For example, 5 minus 7 whole square, 4. Those who want to write down, you can write down. I'll go slow. 5 minus 7 whole square, 5 minus 7 whole square divided by 7. That is 4 by 7 plus 29 minus 26. That is 3 square, 9 by 26. Next, difference is 1, square is also 1, 1 by 37. Next, 25 minus 24, that square is also 1, 1 by 24, 1 by 6. Once again, I am telling, go on putting OI here, first OI, first EI, or first value, 5 minus 7 whole square divided by 7. Second value, 29 minus 26 whole square divided by 26. You go on doing like that and find summation of all this, you will get chi-square calculated 1.15. So what is the degrees of freedom? You should count this 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. What is the degrees of freedom here? Degrees of freedom is 4 because 5 items are there. Hence, you are going to have for 4 degrees of freedom, for 95% confidence, 9.49 is the value. So that 9.49, this should be 9.49 and hence, chi-square calculated is less than chi-square table. Theory is accepted, binomial distribution, whatever is fit, is also a good fit. Now, a die is thrown 150 times. Die means snake and ladder die, where 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, these dots will be there. You might have played many times. A die is thrown 150 times, and the following frequencies are observed. That is, in the die 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, if you observe, 1 has occurred 19 times, 2 has occurred 23 times, 3 has occurred 28 times, 4 has occurred 17 times, 5 has occurred 32 times, and 6 has occurred 31 times. According to theory, all should have equal probability. Out of 150 divided by 6 means 25, 25, 25 times they should occur according to theory. According to practical, this one, whether practical and theory do not differ much, this is the question. Test the hypothesis that die is unbiased. If the theory and practical agree, whatever the die you are using to play, it is good one. Otherwise, it is not good one. So, whether the die is unbiased. Answer. So, I am leaving this answer to you. Chi-square calculated, you will get 7.92. And chi-square table, you will get 11.07 for 5 degrees of freedom. So, that theory is accepted. Hence, die is unbiased. So, just like previous example. So, now, test the theory that predicts production of beans. In the four groups, this is available in many books. So, just like the first example, you have to do this example. First example, that is of Pick's example, very, very similar here. Here, you have to how to find the theoretic here. Practical frequencies are given 882, 313, 287, 118. So, that here, out of 160 beans, so you can find the theoretically out of 160 beans, and this also you can find out of 160 beans and find. Chi-square calculated, you will get 4.72. Chi-square theoretically 7.81. Again, theory is matching with the. This is very similar to the first example. I will go to the variety. This may be our last example, that is sampling. But this example is very interesting. Please read very carefully. If the standard deviation of lifetimes of television, so there is a lifetime for every television, 2 years, 3 years, 4 years. Or number of hours, 2000 hours, 4000 hours, plus or minus, suppose 20 hours. That is, if the standard deviation of, instead of mean, if the standard deviation of lifetimes of television tubes is manufactured by a company is 100 hours, how large a sample must be taken in order to be 99% confident that the error of estimation regarding lifetime should not exceed 20 hours? Here, error of estimation is asked. How to find error of estimation? We shall find. Now, what is sigma? Sigma is given 100. How large a sample should be there? So, what is the question that you underline? How large the sample must be? Means n we have to find. We have to find n. So, now for 99% confidence limits, x bar plus or minus 2.58 divided by sigma by root n. So, this chi-square distribution also for large sample follows normal only. Hence, here this part is known as error of estimation, 2.58 a sigma by root n for 99% confidence. Suppose this is the same example is asked for 95% confidence, please take it as homework. Then simply replace this by 1.96, that time what should be n? If at all you want to be more confident, n should be bigger. If at all, you should be less confident, n can be smaller. So, put it 95% confidence and find n also. For 95% confidence, 1.96 you put and find the similar example. How we have done it? The error of estimate is 2.58 into sigma by root n. That is, this part we have taken for 99% confident. So, 2.58 into sigma by root n is 2.58 into sigma is 100 by root n, 258 by root n. This error cannot exceed 20 means this should be less than or equal to 20. That is the only hint. This should not exceed means this should be less than or equal to 20. So then I square this I interchange 258 by 20 divided by square root of 10. Square root of 10 goes here, 20 comes here. If I take this greater than or equal to root n should be same thing written in a different fashion. That means root n is greater than or equal to 258 by 20. This if I do the arithmetic, it is a 166.41, which is when you do the arithmetic, you find this and square it. When you square it, you will get 166.41. It should be greater than minimum greater than 166 means minimum it should be 167. Means what? If you take a sample of the 167, then you can assume that error of estimation cannot be more than 20 for 99% confidence limits. Suppose you are providing a sample to some company for testing. You test and tell us. But what in your company you will assess that if you give only one or two televisions in only one day, it may burn off. That time your sample size is not correct. If you give 10 televisions also, your sample size is not correct. But how much minimum you should give, that is calculated here. Minimum size should be 167 televisions so that you can ascertain 99% with 99% confidence that your error of estimation will not exceed 20. So dear students, so far in these three lectures we have covered sampling distribution, testing of hypothesis for large samples, testing of hypothesis for small samples, maybe difference of means, and afterwards the third part, chi-square test, gives you whether the theory and practicals are agreeing or not. Please practice all these examples. I'll come up with in the fourth lectures the next part of the second part of or the one more part of the same module 5, which is independent of this joint probability distribution. Till that, see you. Keep yourself safe and practice these examples, and see that same examples first you practice and go to the module question papers, and accordingly you can solve all these. Till that, see you.